The forest is full of riches, a treasury, a tapestry of beauty and life. The forest is full of riches, and the riches of the forest are for all. One life, like a thread of gold, may run through the forest tapestry and tie a thousand patterns into one. One life, like a thread of gold, like this life, this fox. A bobwhite finds food here, and so may a fox. The search for the food of life never ends, and the seeker may fail. Each failure itself begins another search. A search for means to live in the comfort of shelter, a place in the land to be home. The land is our living. The land is the house of our life. A forest is home. This is the work of the Forest Service, to care for the house of the woods, to mend and reweave the tapestry of green and gold and living blood we call a national forest, that its riches may remain for all. Life has a way of finding those who look for it. Home is not always as far from us as we believe. In the night, the creatures of the forest come forth to seek their food, as when the psalmist put them in his song. Thank you. One night a meal may be lost. Another dawn may bring another chance to live. The child of the forest works for his living, long and hard. And simple luck sometimes outweighs the skill of the wild. Though hunger comes and death, the life the forest is grows ripe in the gold of summer. Since we came to this land until now, we wasted the house of the forest we were to have shared, and shot from the sky the eagle we say is America. I do not know if now may be too late to mend the fabric we nearly destroyed, but we must try. In study, in law, in the management of all the Forest Service and all the people who care join their hands to do what can be done. To do what must be done, so these young may learn to be eagles, and this eagle may thrive in the land that it stands for. Forest is life, and the children of life. And we begin to understand this life is part of our own, joined to us by living threads we do not tear apart if we are wise. One corner of the world, on the Huron National Forest, the state of Michigan, the Forest Service, and others with a will to work for life, work together again. It is only here that a nearly extinct bird, the Kirtland's warbler, builds its nest. This songbird must have the young trees, the small jack pine, to provide shelter for its nesting place. During the winter and early spring, when the Kirtland's warbler has migrated to the south, the Forest Service and the state carefully burn the cut-over jackpine areas.
Every fire is kept under complete control, and fire becomes a tool for good. To bring renewed life to the jack pine that needs the heat of fire to open its cones, to spill out its seeds, to grow new trees, the young trees this rare bird must have to shelter its precious nest. Watchful on the ground and watchful in the air, the trained and careful forester can build a fire in a box and keep it there. And out of the fire, like the phoenix in the fable, comes new life for the jack pine, life for the Kirtland's warbler. Only 1,000 Kirtland's warblers in the whole world, but to care for life is to care for the little, the least, because the least is also life and part of all. A forest is a singing bird. A singing bird and all the other creatures that help form the pattern of the wild. The porcupine depends on the growing tops of trees for food. But as he eats, he deforms and may kill the tree. Once the fisher kept the pines and porcupines in a balance that let them live together and let the fishers live as well. But we, for the sake of his fur, drove the fisher away from his forest home. Then we wondered why there were more porcupines and why they killed more trees we hoped would be our houses, our barns, our books. We found an answer. And now we have brought the fisher back home, where he belongs, where he always belonged. Now both the porcupines and we may have the trees we need. There is enough for both, enough for all. Enough for all, because we do not live alone. To live together is not to take too much, and still accept the gifts the forest gives to us, to all of us. Is to plant and to harvest again. So we speak of the harvest of timber and harvesting game. We came from the forest at first, and something in the apple-tasting air of autumn calls us home. For the forest is man, and a hunter may be more than he who shoots. He hears the voice that calls him by name in secret sounds beneath the fallen leaves. A hunter may be more than armed with guns. He knows that what he hunts is part of him. And he can say or sing as the Indian hunters before him, "Come, wild brother, give again your gift of food and life. It is because we love you we put you into our bodies. Is it not a great thing to be food for the sons of chiefs?" Live is to plant, and to harvest, and share our harvest with all. Winter is time for the harvest of timber. A forest is timber. A forest is deer. All winter, deer depend on the leaves of trees and twigs not covered by the snow for their food. In the national forests, timber management and wildlife management work together. The harvester has no need of the small branches and twigs cut from the timber he sells. He leaves them there, in the forest, for the deer that feed on them. There, where the snow is not drifted so deep, and the wind is not so cruel with cold. For the deer is the forest, as much as the tree, as much as the man. Not to manage the timber and wildlife as one is not to care for the forest at all. So too, if all survived, before long there would be no forest. The wild has ways we only begin to understand. In the forest, life depends on death, as much as on life. We say it is rather a change from life to life. Mm-hmm. The little tree is changed to life in the snowshoe hare. The way the sun, the water, and the forest soil are changed to life in seeds and little trees. The way the hare may be changed to a fox. A fox that will someday be changed to soil and little trees. In winter, seeks and finds his mate. It is the charge, the concern, and the duty of the Forest Service to care for the forest itself, so the forest can care for its children and for us, so the riches of the forest may remain, changing life to life for all, forever. Is woven as one, the fox and the flower, the sun and the soil, the water and wings, the toadstools and trees. The forest is woven as one. Plant and animal and mystery and man, the forest is a tapestry, a treasury of riches forever, for all.